Welcome back, everybody. So, I unlocked the Sakura tree, and if I'm going to be completely honest, this one was probably the least difficult out of all of them in order to unlock. And I suppose I'll get into that in a second. As always, if you haven't already, consider subscribing, joining my Discord, follow my Twitter. I do giveaways. A lot of people did not claim their prizes last time, so follow me there, because that stuff is actually surprisingly worth it. Anywho, this trial, or this sort of Sophia, I believe, is the AI that we're all sort of working at. Yeah, these trials are extremely difficult, but in terms of leveling up their reputation, it is so much easier than the other two AIs. Like, you don't need to do the maze as many times. I finished it really fast, and I'd imagine other people will finish it even faster. Unfortunately, I don't see the prize being as cool because it's just a regular old decoration as opposed to, like, the fridge, or as opposed to the warehouse, which are like giant chest storages, but alas, it is interesting nonetheless. So what you're watching up on the screen is me doing it, and I'll go to my thought process with the following two clips, but for this clip right here, let's just take a look. Basically, what you do is you try and kill stuff before the AI can kill it. So you're trying to get it before the AI can kill it. As you move up in terms of difficulty, the AI will switch weapons from a machete to a modded club, and then a slasher weapon with the bleeding damage. I honestly would go either VSS or shotgun, and preferably not Glock or M16, which you'll see me use. You can use those very early on, but as you move later on, yeah, you're going to want something that does a lot of damage. I think even heavy melee would be better than Glock or something like that. Well, yeah. So basically what you do is once you activate this sort of like hot like area, the rewards are even better than the other stuff originally offered in the other two trials, but activate that and try and kill the zombies as fast as possible. For the first thing, immediately four zombies will spawn right off the bat. Try and get these because these are all fast. Occasionally there'll be fat, heavy zombies that drain a lot of your weapons, but usually there's some fast ones, so go for those. When these zombies die, they'll leave sort of blood splatches. Think of it like the toxic spewer spit from Bunker Bravo. Avoid it. It does 10 damage regardless of armor if you sit in it. Obviously, you're going to have to deal with it a little bit when, you know, you're fighting a giant mob or something like that, but make sure to back away just a little bit and ease up, and yeah, you'll save yourself the extra damage. And then run to the outskirts of the zone and try and pick off the characters or the zombies before the AI character can get to it. If you get stuck, I have a grenade launcher. You don't need it. I get much better at it later on, as you'll see in the clip. But yeah, I had the Milk Ore just in case. And obviously, if you're gonna use guns to your advantage. That AI only has a melee weapon. Run, so the zombies have to run, so the AI has to run, and then you can easily just use that to your advantage. Also, I prefer VSS or shotgun or something that does a lot of damage, because these will allow you to get the final hit, not the AI. Right, now we're leaning a little bit more into thought process, what I was thinking when I was actually doing these trials. Now, keep in mind, these trials are a lot harder than the other two trials. I feel like they escalate in difficulty. Okay, so I'm running over here and trying to force that AI to put some distance. He does go for the same character every single time. Okay, and now that there's one thing left, I'm trying to get that AI to do a bunch of damage just so the health is low enough so that I can finish it off. Right there, use the M16, finish both of them off, and just like that. Okay, healing up. And for round two, I prefer to use VSSs, and these are both kind of broken already. Ooh, glass, that's actually really good. But these VSS are already slightly broken, so I would go with these anyways, because they're giant heavy hitting, so that's gonna get a hit. I finish that off, and ooh, okay, not terrible in terms of an opening hand. It wasn't as good as I usually do, but it wasn't terrible. Okay, sticking to the outskirts again, forcing this AI to play distance. I get all of those final hits, and then with this fast, fat zombie, I'm going to just run around in a circle and let this guy wear himself out in terms of his melee, so I get that health low enough so that I can get that final hit. There we go, one, two, and those are all my final hits. Now, if I can target the right things, these fast-moving zombies are your friends, like the fast biter level speed, not bloater level speed. Disease wolf, you're going down too. And then I stay near the outside because then it'll leave all the blood splotches on the outside, so it's a lot easier for me to navigate in case things get into a bind. Now, I'm actually getting kind of tight here, and there's a lot of fat zombies, so I'm just going to swap to the grenade launcher. I get it. A lot of people aren't going to have that, but again, this is not about the cheapest way to do it. This is, I unlocked it on day one. There's no cheapness in that. Right there, ooh. Okay, these rewards are actually pretty good. I can go factory parts. Yeah. So, actually, I'm kind of tight on medkits, I just realized. So, I have to play this round very carefully with very little of the mill core. And immediately, that thing gets a hit. Okay, I actually have to play this really, really... I'm playing it terribly. Okay, yeah, I'm trying to get him to finish. I have to go mill core there. There's double slashers. Maybe I can stutter. Okay, that one's low. I can finish that one off and hopefully... No, that thing gets the final hit. I played that really bad. I should have waited a couple seconds. Disease Wolf, this thing should be dead before that gets here. That thing too. Two big zombies. Okay, I really need to heal there because that's a slasher. Chipping that away. That thing's gonna get the final hit on it. Yeah, right there. There's no way around that. Three zombies. Okay, five hits with the mill core. I guess two of them. That doesn't damage me. That slasher, I couldn't tell if I got the final hit. I hope I did. And then this thingy, chip that one down there, there, and there. These are all my finals. Okay, and then there's just a few more. I have to activate auto healing. I'm that low on medkits. Finish off the last one and barely eke my way through it. Now, right around here, this is the recording where I really, really got my stride. Well, at the very end, at least. So, immediately, first round, I don't get too good of a starting hand. I get three of them, at the very least. That's not bad, but it's still not really good. Just sticking with the default M16, that thing should be dead before that guy gets here. Those are three, one fast, and then two slow. I'm gonna walk around them, and hopefully that AI does a lot of damage with his machete. These things are both very full, so I don't anticipate that. Disease Wolf going down before that. That other fat zombie is probably gonna die by the time I get to it. That goes. Oh, I'm surprised I actually got that one. Okay. There's two fast things, so immediately I just have to grab something out of my inventory. Second round, let's go broken VSS, and I'm very reluctant to do M16, but you know what? Let's do M16. Let's go dog food, actually. Okay, so in the third round, you'll see me really get my stride. So first, obviously, you have the opening hand, right? I actually do really well there. I get all of them. And then I go to the outside of the zone because I want to be able to shoot these zombies before they can even get close. Disease Wolf going down, that goes down. That one goes down, and that one goes down. So look at that. I've already gotten so many kills before that AI can even get close to me. That is insane. And obviously, well, I mean, you didn't see this because I'm going to cut the clip. But off camera, I did mess up on the timing. So yeah, usually you don't have to kill these fat zombies. I prefer to because I tried not to. And the timing was a big issue. Sick Cruncher goes down, that one goes down, both, and that's a slasher, of course. Brilliant. And then right here is where I really got the stride. So if you want to try this, you really can. You group up all of the fat zombies and kill the fast zombies. Remember, timing is going to be an issue on this. So you group up all of those big zombies with bloater level moving speed, and you only kill the fast zombies, so the disease wolves and the fast spider level speed. Obviously, I'm putting grenade launcher there in case of an emergency, because again, timing is not my friend. So yeah, if I literally just leave it up to that, if that AI character starts stealing my kills in the fast zombies, then I'm really screwed. So I want to be able to have a backup plan, and I'm going to start chipping at some of these big zombies. In reality, you don't have to, you can play it risky. There goes that one, there goes that one, and I can see that one's pretty low, so I'm going to steal that kill from that AI. That one goes down, and as you can see, constantly moving so that AI has zero time to swing. That weapon is big, but he's got to be close, and it takes him a very long time to swing. So right there, Disease Wolf goes down, Bloody Pest goes down, and okay, I can see there's just a big blob. I don't really feel like fighting any of those, and if I can keep that AI in motion, I should have enough time. There goes that one, there goes that one, there goes that one. I stole that kill. There goes that one. That's immediately like four, five, or something like that. I ran right into that. Why did I do that? I don't know. There goes that one, that one. And immediately, that's two kills right there without even having to worry about the AI. I'm gonna dodge that, and time's actually getting a little bit tight. Not as good as I would like. Okay, but I really only need one more. There we go. So like all these other videos, at the very end of the video, I go over to my base, right? I go to build mode, and I put down the tree. We watch the tree grow on a peaceful universe. Y'all better subscribe. 200 likes, and I'll chop it down.